If you're one of those people with an intense aversion to being pricked by needles and syringes, then you understand the misery of being injected. Even if you manage to avoid most injections, there is still one activity that will require being pricked with needles, at least for the foreseeable future: blood testing. We need to occasionally have our blood drawn to protect our health and discover what might be negatively affecting our body. But have you ever wondered about the process? Particularly, why blood is drawn only from the veins and not from the arteries? First, we should understand a bit more about arteries and veins. Arteries are blood vessels that carry blood from the heart to the entire body. In arteries, the blood is mostly oxygenated. I say mostly because there are two exceptions where arteries carry deoxygenated blood. First is the pulmonary artery, which transports blood from the heart to the lungs. And the second is the umbilical artery, which carries blood from the fetus to the placenta. Veins are blood vessels that transport blood from the body to the heart, so it mostly carries deoxygenated blood. The pulmonary and umbilical veins instead carry oxygenated blood to the heart. Veins also have valves to prevent backflow and are less muscular than arteries. Venipuncture is the formal term for pricking a vein to draw blood, which is then called venous blood. It can then be used for a variety of purposes, including intravenous therapy, blood sampling, and diagnosis. All necessary supplies must be with you before the procedure begins, including blood-drawing needles, a tourniquet, collection tubes, hand disinfectants, alcohol swabs, adhesive bandages, gauze, and blood transfer equipment. Begin by hyperextending the arm of the patient and putting the tourniquet 3 to 4 inches above the injection site. Tell the patient to form a fist and hold it tight. You must identify a vein. The most common vein in adults is the median cubital vein, a large vessel that makes drawing blood easier. Next, cleanse the site with alcohol swabs. Hold the lower arm, which helps to anchor the vein and stop it from rolling. Insert the needle at a 15 to 30 degree angle into the vein. Use the right tubes to remove the appropriate amount of blood. Remove the tourniquet and then remove the needle. Press down on the site with gauze. Venipuncture specialists are carefully trained to prick at precisely the right spot to draw blood. But again, why is blood drawn from the veins and not from the arteries? First of all, veins are relatively easier to draw blood from, physically speaking, as veins are closer to the skin surface. On the contrary, arteries are located deeper in the skin, so the process would be unnecessarily difficult and potentially dangerous. Pressure in our veins is lower than in arteries, so there is less chance of the blood flowing back through the puncture mark before the tiny wound heals. Basically, next time you're sitting in a doctor's